Hello everyone, today we are going to see some more examples depend on the cubic polynomial. Okay, already we have seen the introduction, what is cubic polynomial, that we have seen. Okay, and now we are going to see some more example from practice. Okay, so see here, first sum is given that the zeros of the cubic polynomial f of x is equal to x square minus 6x square plus 3x plus 10 are of the form a plus b, a plus 2b for some real numbers a and b. Find the values of a and b as well as the zeros of the given polynomial. Okay, here we have to find out zeros of the polynomial, and here see, if you observe here, there three zeros are given. As this is a cubic polynomial, you will get three zeros. So a plus b and a plus 2b are the zeros of the polynomial. Okay, so here as per the rule, we have seen the relation. Okay, we have seen the relation. Suppose there are three zeros, so we know that sum of the zeros will be, what is the sum of the zeros? Coefficient of x square minus of coefficient of x square, that is minus coefficient of x square divided by coefficient of x cube. Okay, sum of the zeros is generally we take alpha, beta and gamma. Okay, so alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus of minus b upon a is the coefficient of x square. Okay, so this we have seen. Now sum of the product of the zeros taken two at a time. Okay, sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time. Okay, so what is that? Sum of the product of the zeros taken two at a time. So this will come c upon a. Okay, what is c here? Coefficient of x upon coefficient of x cube. Okay, so that will be the positive. Coefficient of x upon coefficient of x. Okay, so sum of the product of the zeros taken two at a time. How we write this? Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha. Okay, sum of the zeros is alpha plus beta plus gamma. Okay, this is the sum of the product of zeros taken two at a time. Okay, and last one is product of the zeros. Okay, product of the zeros, what is going to come here? Alpha, beta and gamma, this product. Okay, so what will come here? Minus of constant divided by coefficient of x cube. See here, what is constant here? 10, and here coefficient of x cube is 1. So minus 10 upon 1 is going to come about this example. Okay, so this we write minus d by a. D is the constant and a is the coefficient of x cube. Here we write, what we write here? C by a. C is the coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x cube. A is the coefficient of x cube. Okay, and this is going to become minus d upon a. D is the coefficient of x square. Okay, so this we need to think, this must be clear in front of you, then only we can solve the examples which are depend on the relations of cubic polynomial. Okay, so now we will move towards the example. What is given? See, given that the zeros of the cubic polynomial f of x is equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 3x plus 10 are of the form a plus b, a plus 2b for some real numbers a and b. Find the values of a and b as well as the zeros of the given polynomial. Okay, so what is here? Alpha plus beta plus gamma. Like that, here it is given a plus b and a plus 2b. Suppose we will take the addition of this, then what is going to come according to the relation? Minus b upon a. So that we are going to use here. Okay, so a plus b, a plus 2b, a plus b is equal to, what is going to come here? What is going to come? Minus b upon a. What is minus b here? Minus b is minus of minus 6. Minus of minus 6. That is, we can write here minus b upon a. That is minus minus 6 upon 1. Okay. So a plus a is a plus a. 3a plus b plus 2b, 3b is equal to minus of minus 6 will come 6. So if you divide to the whole equation by 3, then what is going to get here? A plus b plus b is equal to 2. A plus b is equal to 2. Okay, after dividing by 3. So a plus b is equal to 3 to the 6. Okay, so we have now value of a plus b is equal to 2. If you want, you can write here b is equal to 2 minus a, or a is equal to 2 minus b also. Anyhow. Okay, so this is our, this two we are going to use. So a plus b is equal to 2, b is equal to 2 minus a. Okay, now what we are going to think about? Product of the zeros. Product of the zeros. What is product of the zeros? D by, minus d by. Okay, so product of the zeros that I am taking here. Product of the zeros. What are the zeros? A plus b and a plus 2b. So that I am taking here a plus b and a plus 2b. Okay, so is equal to, what is going to come here? Product of the zeros minus d upon a. What is constant here? 10. D is, what is the value of d here? 10. That is, it will come minus 10. Minus 10 upon 1. Coefficient of x cube is 1. So minus 10 upon 1. Okay. So now we have the value of a plus b. A plus b we have 2. Okay. So that value we can replace it. Okay. So a, I am taking here a plus b is equal to into 2. So that is going to come 2a, a plus 2b. Okay. A plus 2b. So we can replace it. We can, here it is a, b is equal to 2 minus a, or we can write a is equal to 2 minus b. Any one value we can put. Okay. So a is equal to 2 minus b, or b is equal to 2 minus a, we can put it. Okay. So a, this value is 2, so that we have taken product of this is 2a, and here what is going to come? A plus 2 into b. What is b? 2 minus a. Okay. So that I am taking here 2 minus a. 2 minus a. Okay, is equal to minus a, as it is. Now what is going to come here? We can solve this bracket. 2a, a plus 2 to the 4 minus 2a is equal to minus a. Okay, so 2a in bracket minus 2a plus a will be this 4 as it is, minus 2a plus a minus a is equal to minus a. Now we need to find out product of this. That is 2a into 4, 4 to the 8a minus 2a square is equal to minus 10, is equal to minus 10. Okay, so now if you will take, if you will divide two whole equation, all the three terms by 2, then you will get the lowest term of this. So that is 2 4s are 8, 4a minus a square is equal to minus 5. So we will bring in the proper form, okay, general form, ax square plus bx plus c. So minus a square, suppose I will take that side, that will be the plus a square. Okay, this will move that side, minus 4a, and this is plus, this is minus 5. Okay, we have taken this in the form ax square plus bx plus c. So a square minus 4a and minus 5 as it is. Now we need to, this is a quadratic equation, we need to factorize it. Okay, so we will get two values. Now minus 5, we need to factorize in such a way the sum product should be minus 5 and the sum should come minus 1. Okay, so which factors we can take? Minus 5 and 1. Minus 5 into 1 is minus 5. Minus 5 plus 1 is minus 5 plus 1 is minus 1. Okay, so this is the correct pair which is satisfying both the conditions. So now we are taking here a square minus 5a minus, sorry, plus a minus 5 is equal to 0. Okay, instead of minus 4a we have taken minus 5 plus a. Okay, splitting middle. Now we can take a common from this, a in bracket a minus 5 plus, we can take here one common, and here it is going to remain a minus 5. Okay, so finally a minus 5 and a plus 1. a minus 5 and a plus 1. So what you will get here, factors a is equal to 5, zeros are a is equal to 5 or a is equal to minus 1. From this we can say a is equal to 5 and a is equal to minus 1. Okay. If a is equal to 5 and two cases will come, a is equal to 5. Okay. So first that we need to solve. So case first is when a is equal to 5. Okay. Afterwards we will say a is equal to 1. Okay. So when a is equal to 5, what is the value of b? That time b is equal to 2 minus a. What is a? 5. 2 minus a. That time b is equal to 2 minus 5 will be minus 3. Okay. When a is equal to 5, b is equal to minus 3. Okay. How we got this? We can put here. In any equation you put, then you will get the value of b is equal to minus 3. Okay. So what are the numbers? A is equal to 5. Second number, a plus b is equal to a is 5 plus b is equal to is minus 3, that is 2. And next one, a plus 2b is equal to a is 5 plus 2 into b is minus 3, so that is 5 minus 6, that is minus 1. Okay, so 5, 2 and minus 1 when a is equal to 5 in that case. Okay, now we will think about when a is equal to minus 1. Okay, that time what is going to come? A is equal to first minus 1, first 0 is minus 1, a plus b we need to find out. How we find out b? B is equal to 2 minus a. Okay, b is equal to 2 minus a. So 2 minus, we need to put here minus of minus 1, that is 2 plus 1, 3. Okay, so how will get this? Minus 1 plus 3, that is 2. A plus b is equal to 2. And next one is a plus 2b. Third 0 is a plus 2b, that is a is minus 1 plus 2 into b. What is b? B is equal to 3. So that is minus 1 plus 6, that is 5. So minus 1, 2 and 5. These are the zeros. Okay, so we have seen one example which is depend on the zeros of the cubic polynomial. Okay, see carefully and solve the same sum in your homework. Okay, see here, our second example is find the condition which must be satisfied by the coefficients of the polynomial f of x is equal to x cube minus ex square plus qx minus half when sum of its zeros is 0. Sum of its zeros is 0. Okay. Once again, see, this is a cubic polynomial. So definitely there are 3 zeros. You will get 3 zeros. Okay. So we will consider first, let the zeros of f of x be alpha, beta and gamma. Okay, 3 zeros are there. Okay, and what is given? See, sum of its 2 zeros is 0. Sum of its 2 zeros is 0. There are 3 zeros, from that sum of 2 zeros is 0. So we can consider any 2 zeros, sum of any 2 zeros is 0. So we can see here, that is alpha plus beta is equal to 0. This we will consider. Okay, sum of its 2 zeros is 0. Alpha, beta and gamma are the 3 zeros, as this is a cubic polynomial. And sum of its 2 zeros is 0. So alpha plus beta is equal to 0. That we have written. Okay. Now we need to think about this. We need to think about f of x is equal to x cube minus dx square plus qx minus alpha is equal to, is this is the given, minus r, when sum of its zeros is 0. Okay. So now what we are going to do, according to this, sum of the zeros is equal to minus b upon it, that is minus coefficient of x square upon coefficient of x square. Okay, so that we are going to take here. See here, alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b upon a. Okay, so alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b upon a. Now we are going to think about this polynomial. Okay, so alpha plus beta we have 0, that we have considered 0 according to the question. Okay, so 0 plus gamma is equal to minus b upon. So what is going to become minus b? What is minus b? Minus b is what? Coefficient of x square. Okay, coefficient of x square is minus b. So that we will consider this minus sign already there, minus of minus b divided by coefficient of x cube is 1. So that is going to become b. So what is the value? Gamma is equal to p. This is the value. Gamma is equal to p. Okay. So now see, alpha, beta, and gamma are the zeros, and gamma is also zero. Gamma is also zero of the polynomial. Okay. So if I want to write this polynomial f of gamma is equal to how we can write gamma q minus p into gamma square plus q into gamma minus r. Okay, so what is getting here? See, what we have done at the base of x, we have taken gamma. Why we have taken gamma? Because gamma is also zero of the polynomial. Understood? So if you put, we can put here zeros. So here alpha gamma is equal to p, value of gamma is p. So that value we can replace at the base of gamma. So here we can write p cube minus b into p square plus q into p minus r. Okay, so p cube minus p square into p is p cube plus q p minus r. Okay, when 0 we will put in the given polynomial, that time what is going to get here? Remainder is 0. Okay, so here remainder is 0. Okay, so here p cube minus p cube will be cancelled. This will be cancelled. Okay, so what is remaining here? Qp minus r is equal to 0. So we can say Qp is equal to r. Qp is equal to r. What they are asking, see, find the condition which must be satisfied by the coefficients. This is the condition. Qp is equal to r. Okay. So once again, see, what was given? A polynomial, cubic polynomial is given. And the condition is given, sum of its two zeros is 0. So we have taken alpha, beta, and gamma are the zeros. Alpha plus beta is equal to 0, that we have considered. As per the relation, alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b upon a. Alpha plus beta is equal to 0, gamma as it is minus b. From this, we can take minus of minus b upon 1, that is p. So alpha is equal to p. Gamma is equal to p. Okay, so gamma is also zero of the polynomial, so we can put in the given polynomial, so the value will be, remainder will be zero. So gamma q minus p into gamma square plus q into gamma minus r is equal to zero. So gamma is equal to p, so we can replace gamma by p. So p cube minus p into p square plus q into p minus r is equal to 0, p cube minus p cube will be cancelled, qp minus r is equal to 0, so qp is equal to r. This is the condition which will be satisfied, which will satisfy. Okay, got it everyone? Okay, see here our third problem is, find the condition that the zeros of the polynomial f of x is equal to x cube minus px square plus qx minus r may be in arithmetic progression. Okay, see here, arithmetic progression, this is new word for you, but the same lesson we are going to study in class 10. Okay, that is chapter number 5. But before that, you must know what is arithmetic progression. Okay, arithmetic progression, we can say AP also, A for arithmetic and P for progression. Okay, so see here carefully, we are going to think about that word specifically. See here, I am taking here 4, 6, 8, 10. Here, okay. Observe this and see what is the difference between both the sequences. What is the difference? 4, 6, 8, 10. 1, 3, 7, 9. If you see carefully, here you will get 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10. Okay, means the difference between two consecutive numbers is same. We can see here 6 minus 4 is 2, 8 minus 6 is 2, 10 minus 8 is 2. Okay, this sequence will be continued. Okay, here see 1 plus 2 is 3, 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 4 is 7 and 7 plus 2 is 9, means the difference between consecutive number is not constant. Okay, so 3 minus 1 is 2, 7 minus 3 is 4 and 9 minus 7 is 2, means the difference between two consecutive number is changing. Okay, so here difference is constant. Okay, in the proper manner this is progressing. So this is known as arithmetic progression. Okay, so that we are going to use here in terms of variable. Okay, so see here carefully. Suppose I just now told you the difference between two consecutive terms is constant. Okay, so suppose I will see here this is a. What will be the one term before? What will be the previous term of A? If A is the term and D is the common difference. So what is going to get here? Before term A minus D. And afterwards what is going to get? A plus D. Afterwards A plus D. These are the three terms. Okay. A, middle term. A minus D. A plus D. Here see. If this we will consider A, and common difference is 2. So A minus D is 6 minus 2 is 4. Correct? And A plus D, 6 plus 2 is 8. Okay. So this way we can represent the arithmetic progression. Okay, with the help of variable in the sense, this is the A is the first term, or A minus D, A plus D. Like that. Three terms if we want to show, then we can do like this. Why we are using here three terms? Because here what they have told us, x cube minus bx square plus 2x minus r, this is a cubic polynomial, so definitely there are three zeros. Okay, so we have taken the arithmetic progression of three zeros. Okay, so maybe in arithmetic progression they have told us, so find the condition that the zeros of the polynomial f of x is equal to x cube minus bx square plus 2x minus r may be in arithmetic progression. Okay, just now we have discussed the relation between the zeros, sum of the zeros means if we are taking sum of the zeros, these are the zeros now we are going to consider. So sum of the zeros a minus d plus a plus a plus d, sum of the zeros what is coming? Minus b upon a. Okay, so minus b upon 1. Okay, so what is going to be here? See a. Okay, minus d and plus d will be cancelled. Okay, a plus a, 3a is equal to b. Okay, so a is equal to what is coming? a is equal to b by 3. Got it, everybody? Now see, a is also zero of the polynomial. A is zero of f of x. Okay, so if you will put here a in f of, if you put here a at the place of x, then remainder will be zero. Okay, so according to that we are going to take f of a is equal to zero. Okay, so in this cubic polynomial we are going to put a. So a cube minus p into a square plus q into a minus r is equal to zero. Okay, f of a means that the given cubic polynomial we have taken, f of a is equal to 0. Why a is a 0? Because these three are 0. We have considered according to this arithmetic progression. Okay, so a cube minus p into a square plus q into a minus r. Okay, but what is the value of a? A is equal to p by 3. So that we can put here at the place of p. So p by 3 cube. At the place of a, we have taken p by 3 cube minus p into what is a? p by 3 square plus q into a is p by 3 minus r is equal to 0. Okay, so now we will solve this. That is p cube upon what is the cube of 3? 3 cube is 27 minus p square into p cube upon 3 square is 9. Okay. Minus plus qp upon 3 minus r is equal to 0. Okay, so now sir, we will multiply here. 9 3 is 27, so here also we need to multiply. Okay, so here 3 9s are, here we will multiply by 9, here we will multiply by 27, here also 27. Okay, so now p cube upon 27 minus 3 p cube upon 27 plus 9 p cube, okay, upon 9 3 is 27 minus 27 r upon 27 is equal to 0. Okay, so see, this is, these are the right terms, okay, because denominator is same. So minus 3 is p cube minus p cube, what is going to get here? Minus 2 p cube upon 27, denominator is same, plus 9 p cube minus 27 r is equal to 0. Okay, denominator is same, so we can write this minus 2 p cube plus 9 p cube minus 27 r is equal to 27 into 0 will be 0. Okay, so if you want to make positive, then it will be 2 p cube, this will be minus 9 p cube plus 27 r is equal to 0. Okay, see carefully what we have done. Find the condition that the zeros of the polynomial f of x is equal to x cube minus bx square plus bx minus r, cubic polynomial, may be in arithmetic progression. Okay, arithmetic progression, I told you what is arithmetic progression, why we have taken this. So a previous term is a minus d and next term will be a plus d. So we have taken this, these are the three zeros, sum of the zeros is equal to minus b by a, so minus of minus b upon 1, 3 is equal to b, a is equal to b by 3. A is a 0 of f of x, so f of a is equal to 0, so we can put in the given polynomial a cube minus b a square plus q into a minus r, but what is the value of a? B by 3. So at the place of a we have taken b by 3, denominator we have done same. Okay, addition, subtraction we have done, and finally we got this answer. So this is the required relation. Okay, got it everyone? So today we have seen just three examples. So see carefully those examples which are important. Okay, solve the same examples in your notebook and the given worksheets also. Thank you.